examines the global scenario. Take a look. In India, it's known as ganja, charas. In Afghanistan and the Middle East as hashish. In the West, commonly as pot, or more lyrically, marijuana. Whatever its name, Cannabis sativa, a herbaceous plant first identified by that name in 1753, has been in use since times immemorial. It has been used as a source of fiber, oil, in food, for recreation, in religious rituals, and as a safe painkiller. William Shakespeare, the greatest playwright of all in the English language, smoked it. There were traces of cannabis on pipes found in Shakespeare's home in Stratford. Indeed, the bard coyly referred to a noted weed in one sonnet. Queen Victoria, the powerful English monarch, suffered from severe menstrual cramps. Her private physician, Sir Russell Reynolds, prescribed marijuana, and in an issue of one of the world's oldest medical journals, Lancet, he described the humble plant as one of the most valuable medicines we possess. A study in the New England Journal of Medicine in 2017 was conducted amongst 1,446 doctors in 72 countries, including the United States. Doctors in favor of marijuana for medical purposes, 76%. American doctors in favor of marijuana use, more than 75%. Overseas doctors in favor of marijuana use, 78%. Some major countries which permit the use of marijuana both for recreational as well as medicinal purposes: Australia, Canada, the Czech Republic, Germany, the Netherlands, Portugal, Spain, 20 states of the United States, and some major countries that ban marijuana: Indonesia, Japan, Malaysia, Norway, the United Arab Emirates, and Saudi Arabia. Padma Rao, WION.
Let's break this down for our viewers. Joining us on the broadcast this evening is Tathagata Satpathy, member of the 16th Lok Sabha. He is a member of the Biju Janata Dal political party and the party's chief whip in the Lok Sabha. Good evening, sir. Thank you very much for speaking with us right here on WION. First up, where do you stand on the contentious cannabis dilemma in the country?
I would like to clarify this right at the outset that I am not, repeat, not speaking on behalf of my political party, the Biju Janata Dal. I have had this as a pet subject for myself for a very long time, from my college days, when I myself I had used marijuana and other products which were not illegal then, and which in my state of Orissa is not illegal even now. You can walk up to a government shop in Bhubaneswar, in Puri, in many other towns and villages, and actually score pot and smoke it, but you cannot possess beyond a certain amount. So there was a limit on that. So this is not a political stand, I believe, because our custom in Orissa, for instance, we have had for many centuries, our elders in villages, even if you go today, you will see that there is this puja called Satyanarayan Puja, which is usually held every Monday evening. Like today is a Monday, 31st of July 2017. This evening there would be hundreds, scores of places where elderly people, youngsters, middle-aged people would be sitting around the big banyan trees in a village and would be smoking chillams with pot, with weed, ganja, marijuana, whatever you call it. And it is not considered a drug, it is not considered something evil. Unlike alcohol, which till today in many families is considered something bad.
Right.
So I have this outlook which I've been holding on for a long time.
Sure, sir. Please stay on with us. Let's take a closer look at what the place of cannabis in India really is. The leaf of the plant is commonly consumed as a milkshake during Holi and is popular among worshippers of Lord Shiva in the month of Mahashivratri. Sadhus in saffron robes are commonly seen smoking chillums, clay pipes containing hashish, the resin of the same plant. Like their international counterparts, Indian medical professionals have also been in favor of prescribing marijuana for its non-habit forming quality to patients of cancer, AIDS and other diseases. So why is the consumption of marijuana still on an official list of banned drugs, a list that includes deadly substances like heroin and LSD? Padma Rao takes a look at the state of affairs concerning marijuana in India.
Charas, ganja, bhang, the resin, the flower and the seeds and the leaves of the cannabis sativa plant have all had a firm place in India's ancient history since way back in 2000 BCE. The Rig Veda lists it as an essential ingredient for soma, a drink used during religious rituals. The Atharva Veda says that cannabis is one of five sacred plants that act against anxiety, and I quote, "The five kingdoms of plants," it writes, "including hemp or cannabis, let them free us of distress." The colonial British were curious enough about the use of cannabis in India to conduct a comprehensive study. They concluded that it produces no ill effects and, if any, were restricted to the user himself. In other words, there were no drunken brawls, the kind that are common outside pubs and in public places all over India today. So if alcohol is legal and a bestseller, as is indeed the most addictive drug on earth, tobacco, when and why was a harmless substance like marijuana banned in India? Blame it on the West. It was an international treaty in 1961 that first clubbed cannabis with hard and deadly drugs like heroin and LSD. The Indian representatives then argued against this seeming intolerance to what is essentially an Indian custom. But given that India was a poor country with no say in international forums, New Delhi had to settle for a compromise and agree to limit its export of hemp and to defining cannabis as only the leaves which are consumed in milk and omit the raisin. In 1985, India passed its own Narcotics, Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act, but as with many other near-defunct British laws, it retained the older definition. Since 2015, many efforts have been made both by Indian politicians and medical professionals to point to the absurdity of the law, and there has been a groundswell of support in the media too. In 2017, India's government seems determined to shake off much of the deadwood that weighs down judicial reform. Union Minister Menaka Gandhi has suggested legalizing marijuana, just like in other developed countries. Politicians are usually not the public's favorites in any country in the world, but Minister Gandhi and other legislative members before her may have just found themselves thousands of grateful fans, especially among those struggling to deal with the excruciating pain of debilitating diseases like AIDS and cancer. Padma Rao, WION.
Going back to Mr. Satpathy for more on that, it's a dilemma that the country has found itself in for the longest time, where there have been many voices coming out in support. Now, in the latest, Union Minister Menaka Gandhi has voiced legalizing medical marijuana, sir. Do you feel that it's time that the country takes a leaf from the other countries and goes ahead with the implementation of that recommendation?
Of course. It should. India should also evolve. Just talking about a new India. See, I personally believe that just talking about business alone does not help unless you socially change a country. And this is one law which is draconian. And I remember it was somewhere in the mid-late 80s, early 90s, when there was a lot of pressure from countries across the world on India. To a certain extent, I also heard that at a certain point of time, some police personnel, some SPs in Himachal Pradesh were given credit notes by the US government if they captured a certain amount of charas coming down from the mountains. Now, my point is that that kind of a foreign intervention was never objected to. I support Mrs. Maneka Gandhi and her move now, recent. But I would like to say one thing. I had spoken about legalizing marijuana way back in 2015 in Parliament. So I have been at it for a long time because I see my people use it, and I cannot sit in judgment of my people because they are my gods, and if they are using it, I do not see any reason to sort of make them do something which is in their custom, but they find themselves on the wrong side of the law. So I believe that sometimes you have to take certain actions, delete certain laws, so that your people, whatever customs they live by, do not accidentally break the law. That should be the first and foremost concern of any legislator. So that was my concern, and that's why I openly, at the risk of being ridiculed, I opted to speak out, because I respect my people who have voted me so very kindly, loved me, blessed me, that I have been in Parliament for 4 terms now.
So, being a parliamentarian, in your view then, what is holding India back all this while when it comes to legalizing marijuana?
See, we are a very bureaucratic country. Politicians actually cannot influence policies very much. Most of the ministers, I am not talking about just present ministers, past, present, I cannot talk about the future, but most ministers and people in government, the politicians who think they are in power, they actually don't go deep into anything. I, even today, earlier during the UPA time, even prior to that, I've been watching Parliament. Most of the ministers do not know what a bill, and trust me when I'm saying this, they do not know what a bill portends unless it is something evil that they have to enact. You know, there are a few people who purposefully want to screw the... Yes.
All right, appreciate those points there, Mr. Satpathy. This, of course, is a continuous debate, a host of issues that, of course, remain to be discussed. Completely out of time on this one. We're going to leave it there, but appreciate your point of view. And, of course, this is a debate which we will be touching upon later on as well. But with that, we're going to be taking a very short break. Coming up on the other side is our second point of discussion coming in from southern India. Stay with us.